Hello everybody, welcome to my YouTube channel and another update of the Cantina Diorama. Welcome friends, thank you very much for coming and liking, commenting, and sharing and all that good stuff you guys do. I really appreciate it. That being said, we're going to do like I do, guys, and go ahead and record a little bit of music, show off what I got going on with the Diorama, and probably talk about a little bit of the future of what's going to happen. All right. So anyhow, I'm going to cue the music. So bear with me a moment and enjoy that little sight right there. In fact, there we go. All right.
Hold on.
So guys, I hope you like that. I'm approaching 5 months. Next week will be 5 months I've been working on this, so let's take a look and see what I got updated for y'all.
Alright guys, I wanted to stop right here because I wanted to talk about what's going on with the texture and the stages that I'm in with that. As you can see, I got three different stages of color going on. I do have the same texture going on. A few little cracks here and there. The wall right there with the vents is finished. Of course, you know, I'll put some more details on it, but I have it matched with the dome that I had done like months prior. Months prior. And then I got it to match really good. All right. So I usually basically after the caulk is applied, I'm ready for a paint after at least 12 hours, but I like to wait 24 just to make sure that the caulk settles really nice and hard, if you know what I mean, because then you can manipulate it because it is very soft. You can cut it with an X-Acto blade or X-Acto blade, whatever you want to call it. And I have some roof junk going on here, just some basic pieces. You might recognize them. I'm not going to tell you what they are. Maybe you can discuss it. I like to use different things that look like things, so that's going to be part of the roof junk. I have a second portion of the back roof I'm doing. I had said in my last update that I was going to be working on the back hanger area, but as you can see, I have been. All right. I have a sandwich on top, keeping the opening to the hanger bay nice and flat. The same technique I use this, because this is all nice and even and flat. I love it. So that looks good. I'll have to cut into here so I can insert this in here. I know it looks phallic. I don't know what that is, but who knows. All right. So yeah, and then this is like the first color I have, and then I do all the browns and grays, and I'm pretty random, but I kind of like try to make some sense that on the edges might have some more wear and tear just from the wind and sand elements on the planet. I got a big old crack and gash here, and that will go through here, of course, but I'll manipulate that later. So I'll just remove the roof junk right here just so I could show you what's going on the inside. So this will open up like this, guys. Okay, I have some junk in there right now because I'm trying to come up with some mechanical mechanisms for the back room by the hangar bay, so we'll see how that goes. And that's the hideout area for all the criminals, which would be all of them. There we go. It pops up a little bit here, but that's okay. Well, I get the hiccups, guys, sorry. But what I'm going to do is I'll probably put a weight in here to weigh it down. Or I might come up with a magnetic system where it's magnetically down. So this right here, this camouflage of color will eventually look like, you know, all this and all the little paint details, the cracks going on, some highlights. And of course, I have a lot of the roof to do. The roof pieces are up here on the table. Same procedure, wash, rinse, repeat, because I think I've done everything at least once, but this is getting to the fun part, because now I'm doing all the details and all the small little stuff, and I keep adding stuff to just really puts a lot of love into it. So anyhow, so I'll just take this. I do have to take these off, so this is good timing. So what I did is with the roof to the hangar bay, I covered it in a masking tape, and then covered it with Mod Podge to give it a nice hard seal on it so it doesn't become too porous. The Cantina is pretty sturdy to have all that weight on there, I tell you that much, don't you think? It was about 30 pounds. All right. So this is the roof here. So this is all for stabilization, you know, and I'll texturize it like I did the others, and I'll do the paint process. You've all seen that process before. The inside of the roof, let me remove that one here to left. The inside of the roof right here, I did the same way as I did the other piece. I lined it with the rulers to keep it nice and straight in different random areas, especially on the edges. And then the ceiling to the back VIP room is now attached to that roof. I decided to go that way. And it makes it nice and sturdy. And then I could just take it off. And then when it's nice and done, it's going to look nice and tailored. And pop that right back in there like that. Pops down. And then I'll have to work on this. This will have a series of lights going on the inside. I like to make them blinking, but we'll see. All right. So yeah, I have to leave that off anyhow because it's dried as well. So I don't want to mash it too much. I hope you like the way it looks. Yeah, a lot of different processes going on right now. I work in a very organic fashion, guys. I hope you like the staged figures and everything. I think the front looks fantastic. I think it looks just like it. Yeah. Alright, guys. Well, that's what I'm working on. So, like I said, I'll be working on the roof. Trying to get that done. That's going to take another day or two. Probably 2 days. Okay, and I have to do that same process with all the roof pieces. There's two more big roof pieces I have to do, and then that'll be it. All right. You guys have an awesome day. You have an awesome weekend. Thanks for coming by. Please like, share, comment. If you can, subscribe. That way you'll get the notifications on all the updates. If you can, follow me on Facebook and follow me on Instagram. Same name. All right, guys. All right. I love you. You be well, and may the force be with you.